My name is Valerie Klesig. 160 years ago, my great-great-great-grandparents carved our 160-acre dairy farm from the Wisconsin wilderness. With help from many neighbors, they harvested the wood and, by hand, built the barn that still stands today. Our barn illustrates the power of collaboration and partnership, a constant driving force in rural Wisconsin. Today, a group of neighbors and partners employs a modern set of tools to address some bigger-than-barn-raising issues facing rural Wisconsin communities. This partnership includes individuals and organizations focused not just on the daily operation of Wisconsin farms. Farmers, environmentalists, and teachers are working together to build the infrastructure for the future of rural Wisconsin. My family hosts an annual barn dance for organizations delivering to Wisconsin the resources essential to farming's future: land, knowledge, and people. My dad, Carl, is part of the fifth generation working our farm. He can talk for a pretty long time about why raising money for environmental nonprofits will positively impact the future of farming.
The land conservation and agricultural communities are two distinctly different groups that share a common denominator: their interest in land preservation. The agricultural community depends on land, which is the base of its business. And the land conservation community values land for its natural beauty and has developed the tools for land protection. And by joining the forces, these partners have become a very powerful voice for permanent land preservation.
The barn dance benefits a couple environmental groups, including Gathering Waters Conservancy and Lakeshore Natural Resource Partnership. The Lakeshore Natural Resource Partnership is a leading environmental organization advocating healthy waters and resource stewardship in northeast Wisconsin. Here's Executive Director Jim Kettler.
Just as Alder Leopold felt that it was our citizens that needed to take responsibility for managing and protecting our land and waters, LNRP feels that the solutions to our environmental issues must come from our communities. And we work to cultivate a strong stewardship ethic for our working lands.
Gathering Waters Conservancy, with support from a lot of Wisconsin farmers, ran a successful legislative campaign in Wisconsin to pass the Working Lands Initiative, which is a law making state money available for permanent protection of agricultural land. Here's Mike Striegel, Gathering Waters Conservancy's Executive Director.
The success with the Working Lands Initiative, I think, has opened up some new doors, some new avenues, again, to reach common goals. A healthy agricultural community in Wisconsin, I think, means a healthy natural community in Wisconsin, and more leaders in both of those communities are working together.
Our longtime friend, Dick Cates, can also speak at length about the importance of resources, land, knowledge, and people to the future of farming. Along with co-director Jennifer Taylor, Dick runs the Wisconsin School for Beginning Dairy and Livestock Farmers. The school educates not just second or third generation farmers, but a new first generation too. So far, it has launched nearly 300 young farmers, and about half these students came from outside agriculture to start their own businesses. The school is unique because courses focus on pasture-based farm management, as well as business and financial planning.
We have to recognize that to do well as a farmer, you have to be an exceptional person. It's not just about throwing hay bales. It's not just about, so that's the old image. So we have to understand that whether you're going to be a doctor or a lawyer or a candlestick maker, you need to have training in how to be an entrepreneur, because you're building a business and a life.
Everett Yope, a student intern on our farm, can attest to Dick's statement. When I spoke with Everett, who plans to run his family's farm and auction business someday, we discussed the challenges confronting young farmers like him.
It's a lot tougher for a 60-herd dairy to survive today compared to a 2,000 or 4,000 cow dairy. We're seeing that more education is needed to make it. It's kind of the end of the you can just take over your dad's dairy.
After I interviewed Everett, he and I walked back to the barn in time to hear retired UW professor Jerry Apps describe a timeless theme woven into the fabric of rural Wisconsin.
These barns were not erected by construction crews, but they were erected by neighbors, friends and neighbors and relatives. These old barns came together in a matter of hours, a miraculous kind of community effort.
While it once took just a day to raise a barn, it takes years to convince legislators to commit public funds for land conservation and to educate aspiring agriculturalists. The tools have evolved, yet partnership remains an essential ingredient in rural Wisconsin and its farming communities. This stance, a celebration of rural culture in a restored barn, isn't nostalgic, but forward-looking. While I don't know if I'll be the sixth generation to run our farm, it's so encouraging to see so many partners looking out for the agricultural world my generation is going to inherit.